Bubba is an eight-time world champion. Stoiker, a four-time world champion, and also European Wushu champion. Question about the gas tank hood. Kebab is even here in humid Yangon, Myanmar. Where do you see Kebab is doing what he always does? Getting on the inside. Continually move forward for the Moroccan in the white. Stoiker probing with the jab. Both men in orthodox stance. Outside leg kick from Stoiker. Jab outside leg kick to Romania. Nicely done. Threads the overhand right. Jabbing well here, Stoiker, early on, Dragon.
Throwing a lot of heavy shots. You can hear them from over in the commentary booth. Stoiker is not holding back at all. He knows what Kebabez is capable of. He knows exactly what Kebabez wants to do. You can see Kebabez inching forward, trying to get on that inside. And Stoiker's trying to keep him around and puts him down with a right hand.
Knockdown, says referee Owanari. Big right hand there from Kebabas. Stoiker returns the favor. This one's a Donnybrook early on. Jabs again from Stoiker. Inside thigh kick. Kebabas backs him up. There's the uppercut, the outside leg kick. This is a fine kickboxing contest inside the One Super Series cage. Kebabas goes body, head, legs. Combination work again from the Moroccan. Stoiker goes to the liver off the left hand. Toe-to-toe, neither man giving each other an inch. Four-time world champion Stoiker, eight-time world champion Kebabes.
See the way Kebabes throws those combinations. He puts combinations together beautifully. It's that very exemplary of a Dutch-style kickboxing, the way he punctuates that leg kick. Look at the way he throws that. Ba-ba, boom, punch, just landing that leg kick deep.
Bouts is work rate for a man of this size is phenomenal. He never stops working. High output, high volume. Lands a lot. And again, the uppercut lands, the body shot. Stoiker jabbing between the guard. Goes body to Stoiker, both sides of the carcass. To line up the right hand there, Kebabes. Uppercut to right hand for the Moroccan. Good turn right there from Stoiker. Both of them take a shot. They are fighting in a phone booth at the moment, Pitch.
Yeah, they could just be, they're standing toe to toe. And they're throwing a lot of combinations. You can see Kebabes mixes the body, head, body beautifully.
Oh, Kebabes is a house on fire. Stoiker's got a chin and a half under that beautiful beard. Right hand backs him up. Kebabes, house on fire, owns the first round.
Wow, the way Kebabes lifts up Stoika's head with that uppercut. There is something special there, and I think he's going to set up a big shot soon. There it is. Look at that. Four punches and then a leg kick. You can hear that leg kick just thud. And when you get big shots to the body, that slap, but when you get the thud, that's the scary shot, Mike, because you know that you feel that shot deep inside your very being. And your ancestors can feel those leg kicks. They're coming with that much force and that much velocity. Check out Kebabes on his feet, not even breathing heavy. Looks like he just stepped out of the shower, though. Stoika's on his stool, taking some advice from his corner.
Second round of 3-1 Super Series kickboxing match. Tarek Kebabes, eight-time world champion. Andre Stoiker, four-time world champion. We've got over 120 martial arts champions here at One Championship. Two of them in the game at the moment. Kebabes, what a dominant first round. Ownership with the combination, with the hands. Renowned for his kicks, Kebabes. It's all about the boxing of the Moroccan powerhouse.
Stoiker's trying to use those kicks to keep that distance, but he just can't keep Kebabes off of him. Kebabes walks through these shots, lands that uppercut again.
Put the chin through the top of the head of Stoiker out of the hand fight. Down to the
you can't catch and hit and throw a shot. You have to catch, let go, and then throw a shot.
Referee Stoiker. Barbez takes the left hook. That was a solid one too. And Kababez looks like he's hurt. This is Stoika's opportunity now. Hey, what, Mitch? This looks like an old school K-1 match.
Yeah, this is old school kickboxing. Oh, this is where you come from, man.
Left hook, uppercut, combinations again from Kababez. This has just guts and intestinal fortitude. This is toe-to-toe battle. Two big right hands from Stoika and an uppercut from the Romanian. Kababez checks the low kick, fires off a right cross. Jab, right, liver, hook. Kababez more combinations than a Sudoku puzzle. Jab again, uppercut from the Moroccan goes the body. Almost got the ring lights. And here's Stoika going to the body, going to the liver like he's digging for oil.
Stoika answers right back with a body-head combination of his own. But look at the overwhelming volume coming out of Kababez. Stoika may throw four or five shots, but Kababez puts together 8 out of 10 shots.
This may be the best ONE Super Series kickboxing match we have seen yet. High kick there from Stoika.
That's what I like to see from Stoika. Change things up. Add those kicks in.
Barbez is launching everything behind that left hand. The Moroccan always on the front foot. There's the right down the tube. There's the left of the liver, the right hook, the uppercut. Punches and punches strung together here from Tariq Kababez. The volume, the output of the Moroccan keeps coming forward. Backs up Stoika 5 places with a right cross. Uppercut to right cross there from Kababez. He does not relent. He does not give you an inch, not a millimeter. No breathing space at all. Kababez again.
That's what he does so well. There's no room to breathe. It's just that constant pressure. He's just walking forward. He normally pins people up against the corner and just unloads on him, but Stoika's using the cage very well. I think that's his mixed martial arts background.
Oh, rubber leg.
Huge right hand.
Rubber leg for Stoika. How is he still standing? And again, left hooks now from Kababez. Smack bang. The Moroccan with the power, with the output. Another great round from Tariq Kababez.
The beard on Stoika, both literally and figuratively, Michael, is awesome. He ate a lot of shots, but he also gave back a lot of shots. Look at these guys just trading. The way that he goes to the body and then lands that uppercut is absolutely poetry in motion. It's beautiful coming from Kababez. But then Stoika is in it every step of the way, answering back with shots of his own and really pushing the pace on Kababez. Because every time Kababez starts to answer, Stoika comes right back. What a highly entertaining first two rounds in this ONE Super Series from, what do they got, 12 world titles between them, Michael?
Amazing again, he sends a message. The 8-time world champion stands. The 4-time world champion sits. Third and final round, Andre Stoika, Tariq Kababez is a throwback to the heady K-1 days. He opens up again with the looking punch. Look how he walks Stoika back. Left hook, straight right cross, body head, changing levels. Stoika, step up knee. What an experience for Stoika. First time competing in Asia, and it's here in the cauldron, the stuffy, sweaty, suffocating cauldron of the 200 indoor stadium. Kababez rips to the liver. The uppercut blocks the head back.
Stoika can't allow Kababez to pressure up against that cage. He's got to keep circling out. That's what Kababez does his best work.
Kababez showing why he's the most impressive big man in ONE Super Series. Just keeps coming forward. Just keeps working. There's no kicks from Kababez. It's all hands. It's all boxing. All on the inside.
And he was adding the low kicks in, Michael. I like how he was ending the combinations with the low kicks.
Saliva out of the mouth of Stoika. Stoika tries to rally. This is all tenacity and intestinal fortitude from Stoika. It's all combinations and power. from Tarek Kebabes again on the inside, uppercut, and the cracking leg kick. Kebabes immediately goes to center cage, halfway through the final round. Look how high the gloves are on Kebabes. He grunts, he comes forward like a bull, like an ox. Bangs to the body, then goes upstairs to the head, and Kebabes walking him down. Walking down the Romanian, backing up Stoica, goes body, goes hit once more. Solid right hand from Stoica. Stoica getting a little gassed here now. Kebabes rips to the liver, then goes up to the temple, then the uppercut and the leg kick. It's more combinations again from Kebabes. Oh, there goes the mouth guard. Smack bang, 1-2 shot from Kebabes. Wow. I'm actually surprised the referee stopped that midway through the flurry by Kebabes, Mitch.
An athlete's safety is our number one priority here at ONE Championship, and the mouth guard popped out. You can see
Kebabes disappointed, saying, well, he spat his mouth guard out. That's what Kebabes is saying. He spat his mouth guard out.
I don't think he spat it. I think he knocked it out.
Kebabes not happy, but he is the dominant force here. No doubt about that. The eight-time world champion showing us why he's had gold around his waist eight times. And again, little shots to the stern, suddenly kicks. This is just superb. This is kickboxing poetry in motion. You won't find better kickboxing of this weight than you've seen from Tarek Kebabes right now. He's staggered Stoica again. Continually coming forward, backs up the Romanian, puts him on rubber legs, damages the body, damages the head. Stoica nowhere to go. High knee here, 20 seconds remaining now. It's all one-way traffic. It's all dominance. Sign the pink slips, sign the ownership papers, because Tarek Kebabes is going to take another win in ONE Super Series, and this has been his most emphatic victory yet. There it is.
Didn't quite get the KO that he was looking for, but put on a performance to capture the hat trick here in ONE Super Series. That was absolutely beautiful. Combination display, just overwhelming. Stoica at every moment, on every exchange. Kebabes really put together those punches well, landed a lot of leg kicks, but did a lot of damage with that uppercut and those hooks to the body. Look at that. See, he didn't spit it out. He knocked it out.
What a performance from Kebabes. Absolute domination from the Moroccan. The human battering ram has done it again. Here's Dom Lack.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the blue corner, Tarek Kebabes.
3-0 in ONE Super Series. Time world champion, simply unstoppable. No signs of fatigue. Three rounds solid, coming forward on the inside and just pulverizing Stoica with his hands. Tarek Kebabes, two knockouts, one decision, 3-0 in ONE Super Series. Maybe some sketchy officiating in that one. I thought he won it. A lot of people did. A lot of the Japanese did too, Mitch. And that's why they embrace him here in Japan. And they're all behind Rod Tang tonight.
They definitely appreciate his Bushido spirit. Immediately attacking that leg. Inside and out.
4 ounce gloves, a Muay Thai contest. Rod Tang, the Tang Chik Wang Don in the red and silver. Hakim Hamesh of France in the white and black. Goes to the inside thigh, just Rod Tang. Good right hand there from Hakim Hamesh. Hamesh, a world Muay Thai champion, multiple times, should not be underestimated, has speed, has precision. We'll need to rely on those two things and the volume against Rod Tang.
I'm surprised how Hakim Hamesh is not moving. He's standing right in front of Rod Tang and letting Rod Tang just hammer on that lead leg.
Let's see how long it takes for Rod Tang to get on the inside and start to land the leather at the moment. Kicking range from the Thai. Hakim Hamas drifts off to his right. There's a right hand, smack into the kisser, one to the liver, goes off the left from Rod Tang. Uppercut elbow from Rod Tang. Already the heavy artillery being launched in the opening round. Kicks to the midsection from the tank, Rod Tang. Ooh, Hakim Hamas stunned with that left hand and a turning left hook there from the Frenchman. Two of the best Muay Thai countries in the world. Well, the best Muay Thai country in the world, Thailand. And you talk about the Western world, well, in history, France is right up there with the Dutch. Maybe a little behind, but not far. You may talk about the best Western Muay Thai stylist of all time. There's a big argument to be made for a Frenchman named Danny Bill. Jab two there from Hakim Hamas.
Interesting strategy right now for coming from Rod Tang. You can see that first minute was all about the leg kicks. He was just hammering that big leg of Hamas inside and out. Now he's choosing to go to the body. You can see the welds starting to add up on that right side of Hakim Hamas's body. He's attacking with push kicks as well. I think he's trying to soften Hakim Hamas up, trying to get him to drop that arm and then start to go headhunting.
Catch and counter there from Hakim Hamas. A lot of great French kickboxers and Muay Thai athletes over the years. The likes, as I said, of Danny Bill, maybe the greatest. Jerome Labana, Dita Diafat, who was an 11-time world champion. Looping left hand there from Hakim Hamas. Looking to follow in the footsteps of the Muay Thai greats. We're talking Samar Payakaru now. Yodsanklai, Fairtex, Sunshine, Hechpunchu FA Group, Diesel Noi. Such a long list from the land of smiles. Referee Elias Delapsis right on top of the action here. Final seconds of the opening round. It's been entertaining, but really still a filling out process between these two champs.
You can see that, you know, that in the early, in those first 90 seconds, it was all about Rod Tang attacking the legs, and then he went to the body, and that's where he finished that round. But Hakim Hamas was able to land a nice right hand to rock Rod Tang. Rod Tang ate it down and kept moving forward. Look at that. Beautiful. Touching Rod Tang on the chin, gives him a little smirk, and then just starts throwing. Hakim Hamas has got to be a little bit more active. He's connecting when he goes first. He can't allow Rod Tang to start hammering the legs and the body. He's got to make sure he keeps that right hand glued to his chin, because you can see Rod Tang starts swinging those big shots. He touches you once, he'll sleep you.
Second round of three from inside the sold-out Ryogoku Kokugikan in Tokyo. A little more than 1 hour away from our main card. A big hello to all of our Thai fans cheering on Rod Tang Jitmondon. They'll be watching live tonight on Thairat TV 32. Hakim Hamas just goes towards his corner as the cage door closes. Now we should see Rod Tang pick up the intensity. In those 4 ounce gloves, there is no room for error. Accidental groin strike there on Hamas. Roundhouse kick, and again from Rod Tang. Good jab from Hamas, the jab to it, full extension from the Frenchman. Left hook to a right hook from Rod Tang, the tank. Step through knee, Hamas. Nice dump there from Hakim Hamas.
Hakim Hamas is not giving an inch to Rod Tang. He is standing right in front of Rod Tang and trading shots with him. We've seen Hakim Hamas, a beautiful counter striker when he wants to. The beautiful sidestep that he performed on Oga Sawara to knock him out in one of the final rounds was absolutely brilliant. But this time, he is going toe-to-toe with one of the best strikers in ONE Championship.
Some really good refereeing here from Elias Delapsis, allowing the clinch to go on. Both men staying busy. Uppercut trying to snake in that right arm there. Rod Tang worked the clinch around the back of the neck. Can't get it on at the moment though. Needed midsection, folds him in half. Elbow tried to come over the top. There's a step uppercut elbow from Rod Tang off the lead arm. Crossing elbows from both men. Another crossing elbow from Hakim Hamas, uppercut from Rod Tang. Good crossing elbow to the jaw from Rod Tang. Just losing his footing there, Hakim Hamas. Rod Tang has gone to the next level here in the second round. Good cover up. Goes body at Hamish. Hamish returns the favor. 1 minute five remains. Second round of three. Thailand versus France. Two traditional Muay Thai rivals. Two phenomenal Muay Thai countries.
Man, Bunting is known as just a destroyer. He just comes forward and he runs through everybody. But he's also very technical. Watch him inside the clinch. The way that he parries arms, the way that he blocks biceps. He is controlling so many different aspects, especially at this close range. It's extremely impressive. Watch that clinch game. See how he controls the biceps like that to prevent Hamesh from grabbing his head.
Beautiful liver shot there from Rodzang. Hakim trying to get inside the guard, hugging through the forearms of Rodzang Chikwandor and dumps him to the canvas. Nicely done from Rodzang.
Beautifully done. The way that he came, Hamesh was coming forward, Rodzang sidestepped, swept out the support leg and put Hamesh face down.
Look how Rodzang wears these punches in the forearms, waits for a pause from Hakim Hamesh and then pounds to the body. Excellence in execution from Rodzang. Comes forward again to the tie, escapes the uppercut attempt, fires out a front kick, one more round to go. Once again, folks, scoring on a 10-point must system. The winner of the round gets 10 points, the less dominant boxer gets 9 points. Where are you watching around the world? Live on Facebook, live on Twitter, live on the One Super App, live on YouTube. How are you scoring it?
Watch this brilliant work coming from Rodzang inside the clinch. Look at that control on that overhand side. Unable for Hamesh to get inside. Soon as Hamesh tries to bring the hand up, Rodzang is able to come over the top and land that forearm to the chin of Hamesh. He's just showing so many different skill sets every time we see him. We normally see him as this destroyer, this walk forward, just bum-rushing people, landing big shots, taking shots, but he's got a technical side to his game that is absolutely beautiful.
Third and final round of this One Super Series Muay Thai clash between Rodzang Chikwandon of Thailand and Hakim Hamesh. Sold out crowd inside the Rio Goku Kokugikan in Tokyo for a new era, the first time ever the ONE Championship has landed on Japanese soil. Great sportsmanship and respect from both of these warriors. Early dump there from Rodzang.
Again, beautifully sidestepped. Fell Hakim Hamesh pushing forward. Sweeps the head out.
Another dump from Rodzang. Now, while those might not necessarily score for Rodzang, what it does is it mentally deflates Hamesh. It means he's got to pick himself up off the canvas. Here comes Hamesh with a powerful right hand now. Step through knee for the Frenchman and a crossing elbow. And Rodzang responds. Dumps him again. Continually Hamesh having to pick himself up from these dumps of Rodzang Chikwandon.
It's deflating, it buries your ego. Look at that control, it just shows the dominance that the Iron Man has inside there. The way that he's able to sidestep, sweep, and then he uses his hand to parry the head down of Hamesh to add even more force to the fall.
Clinch, chance for the knees. Late knee thrown there from Rodzang. Comes forward again, that high double forearms guard, throws the uppercut on the hook, uppercut from Hamesh, crossing elbow, trying to open the cut on top of the head, glancing right hand from Hamesh. Got to be careful not to drop that head too low. He'll open himself up for a rising knee with Rodzang. Referee Elias Dolapsis breaks him. 1 minute 35 remains, third and final round, a Muay Thai contest here in Tokyo. And another dunk from Rodzang. I've lost count, Mitch.
Michael, you can see that Rodzang has adapted his guard very well to the small gloves. It's very hard for Hamesh to land the hooks to the head. You can see him landing them. And the way that Rodzang is wearing those on his forearm is extremely professive. I'd like to see Hamesh throw uppercuts. I'd like to see him how he's working the body. That works well, too. Uppercuts to the body shots are going to be how he's going to get this round.
Jab two from Hamesh, a little slow though now from the Frenchman. Glancing left from Rodzang, step up elbow from the Thai. Crossing elbow, went all out on that one. Rodzang certainly has some powerful salvos left here with 45 seconds on the clock. Hakim Hamesh glances towards his corner. they are imploring him, but it's in French. I don't know what they're saying, but I think I get the general gist. It's come forward. You've got to throw hell for leather now. Uppercut from Hamish, listens to his corner.
There's the uppercut. Now he's going to find those holes in Rod Teng's guard. He's got to land those uppercuts.
Come on.
Go to the body.
They're out.
Nice elbow there from Rod Teng to the orbital of Hakim Hamish. There's the uppercut from the Frenchman.
Rod Teng is using those elbows beautifully. Every time he gets into range, every time he's able to control the positioning of the arms, he's able to sneak those elbows right over the top and connect.
Final seconds of a brilliant contest. And we go down to the judges. Look at the respect. Look at the honor. Look at the martial arts values displayed from these two world champions.
Man, it all came down to those close-range weapons of Rod Teng. Look at that. He's able to slip the big left hook coming from Hamesh, but then he's able to answer right back. Lance shot. Look at that. He just wears it on the chin, marches forward, shrugs the head up, but then watch the work of Rod Teng inside that clinch. Look how he parries the arm down, gets him thinking about the other side, and then lands another big forearm. These are just barely missing and landing with the forearm and not the elbow, because Hakim Hamesh is so good at manipulating distance. Very close round, very entertaining match here in the ONE Super Series.
How do you score it, folks? Wherever you're watching around the world, you have it for the man right of screen, Rod Teng. You have it for the Frenchman left of screen, Hakim Hamesh. For each round, 10-9. The winner of the round gets 10 points. The less top of the boxer gets 9 points. Our judges, three of them, Cage Sky, tally up the scores. And that's how we declare the winner of the bout. It's called a 10-point must system. Rod Teng, undefeated in ONE Super Series. Will he stay that way, the youngster? As Mitch said, he combines power with exquisite technique. And Hakim Hamish has speed. Had precision, just couldn't find the power he wanted with the uppercut. Let's go to Tom Lau with our decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 3 rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. Judge number 1 calls this bout in favor of the red corner. Judge number 2 scores this bout in favor of the blue corner. And judge number 3 scores this contest in favor of your winner by split decision from the red corner.
It was a close one, and it goes to the tank. And once again, the martial arts honor, respect, courage and integrity being shown. Rod Teng, the Iron Man, Jim Bungon, wins again in ONE Super Series. 3 rounds of kickboxing action in 4 rounds gloves. Look out for the cross and the left round kick of the southpaw, Yodsanklai. He opens up with that round kick early. Another round kick by Yodsanklai, that one to the body. He'll try and smash the ribs. He'll try and break down the forearms of Andy Souwer. Souwer's got to rely on volume. Oh, he gets caught early! He gets caught early! Those 4 rounds gloves of Yodsanklai Fairtex. He is vicious.
Those 4 rounds gloves are life-changing. They can take your health. And when they're coming from Yodsanklai, they will do just that. Souwer's got to be careful. It's the speed of Souwer against the power coming from Yodsanklai.
Yodsanklai has been an absolute beast in ONE Super Series so far, undefeated, and he has been destroying opponents. Another roundhouse kick to the upper right ribcage. Souwer lunges forward, a straight right cross, an inside thigh kick. Sauer's got to throw that right hand all night long. It's public enemy number 1 of the southpaw. And Yod will take his time. He'll maintain his composure. He'll methodically pick Andy apart and look for an opening to drop the power salvos. Outside leg kick from Souwer. Souwer's always been renowned for 2 weapons in particular, his leg kicks and his liver shots. Nice knee on the inside there from Yodsanklai. under these kickboxing rules in one super series, you can clinch a knee for up to 3 seconds. Got to stay busy in the clinch. Yod controlling center cage. Souwer on the outside, but drifting dangerously into the power side of Yod. There's the uppercut that Yod used to knock out Regis from Australia, Lewis Regis, last December. Three uppercuts in a row.
Go!
Regis said after the first punch of their match, he'd never been hit so hard in his life. And it's a common story from everyone who faces Yodsanklai, even his sparring partners. They've never been hit as hard as Yodsanklai Iway Fairtex. You talk to Wayne Parr, who fought Yodsanklai four times. Wayne will tell you every time he fought Yod, it took 10 years off his life. That's how hard Yodsanklai Fairtex hits.
Okay.
We're starting to find that Souwer's able to close that distance well. He's trying to avoid that left side of Yodsanklai, and he's moving. Now he's starting to drift a little bit more out to his left to avoid that big shot. You can see how patient Yodsanklai is.
The uppercut there for Yod, and the left hand. Souwer trying to duke it out of the phone box. It may be a mistake here from Andy. Now he drags some distance, goes for a high kick. Yodsanklai again. The uppercut under the chin almost takes his beard off. Souwer drives him down the canvas, and Yod just smiles at him. No jumping allowed in this one. It's a kickboxing contest. A caution there from referee Onari. What a start from Yodsanklai. The phenom, the hero, the boxing computer. Round kick to end it. We are scoring based on a 10-point must system. Three judges cage side give the winning boxer a 10-point round, the less dominant boxer a 9-point round.
Look at that, beautifully timed. It happened so quick, we barely had a chance to see it, but it was just that short right hand that forced Souwer to drop to a knee. But then, this is where Yod is most dangerous, when he starts teeing off with you, against, when your back's against the cage, there's no place for you to go. You can't hide that power, and it's like the cage is able to just make the power even greater because there's no place for you to go. There's no movement allowed. He traps you there and he just unloads on you.
It will be a 10-8 opening round for Yodsanklai Fairtex, scoring a knockdown on Andy Souwer. Plenty of instructions in both corners. Team Fairtex with Yodsanklai. Second of three from inside the sold-out Rio Goku Kokugigan in Tokyo. For one championship, a new era. Andy Souwer, multiple kickboxing world champion. Yodsanklai, multiple Muay Thai world champion. Yodsanklai, the southpaw, left of screen, edges forward. Crochet armbands around the biceps of Yod, sticks a beautiful jab on the schnoz there of Souwer. Buckled him at the knees. Souwer needs to go to that lead leg, that common peroneal nerve, about four fingers width above the lead knee of Yodsanklai. You break down the leg, you'll slow the boxing. Yodsanklai with these 4 ounce gloves is something else. Souwer needs to find the output, the volume, the work rate, get in, get out, land his shots, work the angle. But not stand flat footed in front of Yodsanklai. Oh, Yod takes him again. There's the left hand, the big come off from Yod. And Souwer down for a second time in this contest. He may not get up. The count's on. It's good night, Irene. Well, Souwer protesting with the referee, but he could not make the count. And Yodsanklai gets his revenge here in Tokyo. Yodsanklai Fairtex in 4 ounce gloves was always going to be an absolute monster.
Wow, he was able to hurt him early with that right side. We were so worried about the left side of Yod that he was starting to connect with the right. He was able to land that stiff leg, wobbled him a bit, but then, well, see, like I said, when he gets you back against the cage, that's when he's scariest. The left hand finds a home, touches Souwer on the chin. Souwer drops. He wasn't able to answer the count. Some slight protesting, but look at that. Boom, hits him right on the nose, and Souwer goes down. Redemption, Yodsanklai.
That's right, Yodsanklai Iway Fairtex is one of the best in the world. And there's another world champion, our own Stamp Fairtex. Let's go to Tom Lau, make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Atsushi Onari, has called a stop to this contest after 51 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of knockout, Yodsanklai, I weigh Fairtex.
Undefeated in 8 years, a 30-plus match winning streak, a rematch 11 years in the making, and the hero Yodsanklai Fairtex reigns supreme. Who can stop this man? Who can stop Yodsanklai Fairtex? Yuya Wakamatsu said he'd knock out Demetrius Johnson.
Watch DJ's forward pressure. He's constantly switching stances. He advances his stance as he punches. So as he throws weapons, he's constantly changing. It's incredibly difficult to read, and that's the danger of it. If he mixes in the takedown so very well. But good job by Yuya Wakamatsu to press DJ up against the cage. Wakamatsu's got to separate here.
Snaky knees on the inside from Demetrius Johnson. Threads one high, then goes down to the thighs of Wakamatsu. Wakamatsu breaks free, back to center cage. Opening 45 seconds, plenty of action thus far.
That first minute is going to give Yuya Wakamatsu confidence, especially with that striking. He's going to be able to, if he realizes he can stop the takedown of DJ, he's going to throw with a little bit heavier shots.
Plenty of movement here from Demetrius Johnson. High kick from DJ. Mighty Mouse goes upstairs. And will we see Wakamatsu let his hands go? That high knockout right on Yuya Wakamatsu. And we're on the ground for the first time, and look at Johnson go to work. Now back on their feet. Johnson sinking a double leg.
Good sprawl by Yuya, but you can't just stop one takedown. You have to stop a chain of takedowns that come off of DJ. He continuously attacks, but good job by Yuya Wakamatsu. Now he's got to go chest to chest. He's got to break the grip, and he's got to spin him around and put his chest to the chest of DJ.
The most anticipated debut in the world. The one championship debut of Mighty Mouse Demetrius Johnson, the greatest flyweight of all time. And now it's Johnson on his back. Wakamatsu inside the guard, and the crowd here inside the Ryokoku Kokugeika loves it.
Good job by Yuya Wakamatsu to stop that single leg that DJ attempted and spin around and have him the guard of DJ. Let's see how quick he got back up.
And listen to them chant, Yuya, 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 here in Tokyo. DJ was making his way back up. Sneaky there from Wakamatsu, back to center cage. 2:35 remains in the first. A tantalizing opening round. Fakes there from Wakamatsu. Fake there from Johnson. Southpaw start for Demetrius, now the orthodox. High knee from Demetrius Johnson, they clinch up once more. Johnson forced against the cage, overhook on the right arm of Wakamatsu. What does Wakamatsu look to do from here, Dragon?
Right now he's just trying to slow DJ down. You know, he's got the underhook on the right side, and now he's got the underhook on both sides. Now he's got double underhooks. Now if he can create a little bit of separation here, he can jack up that side on the right side of DJ's arm and work to the back. But here he goes, there's that separation.
Held up the job, and Jenny King had already through to the semifinal round of the Flyweight World Grand Prix. Inside thigh kick, nicely done there from Demetrius Johnson.
Now DJ is used to going 5 rounds. He has been through 13 straight 5-round matches, and so this is the first time he's been in 3 rounds in a long time. So he's usually used to pacing himself. How is that going to factor into this match?
First time competing in Japan from Mighty Mouse Demetrius Johnson. Left foot there from Johnson, counter left from Wakamatsu, and a high-up roundhouse kick.
Yuya Wakamatsu is looking really good in these first 4 minutes, but he always looks good in the first round. How is he going to favor in the second and third round when DJ starts to shift up gears?
He's doing a good feeling that DJ is just dipping his toes in the proverbial water here. seeing what Wakamatsu has to offer, what angles he comes at, what technique he throws, off what side. Shooting double leg, takedown there from Demetrius Johnson.
Beautiful takedown from DJ as he laces up the legs. Yu Wakamatsu's got to try to get back up. He's going to try to create a little bit of space with his hips. But see how DJ's got that body lock, and he's able to scoop the hips out and easily passes into side control. This is where DJ's dangerous. He's got to watch that far arm. He's going to go for the Kimura on this side. And that right arm of Yu Wakamatsu. Watch him try to pin that arm to the ground, and he's going to go hunting for a Kimura.
Wakamatsu gets that far arm free, still in side control, cuts the hip in a little bit. Demetrius Johnson, great bird's eye view of the action. Wakamatsu back to his feet, the crowd enjoy it. A round of applause inside the sold-out Rio Goku Koku Gikan in Tokyo.
That was nice by Yu Wakamatsu to get that little bit of space and get back up to his feet. Very entertaining round. I know many people didn't expect to go this far.
Heavyweight champion of the world, Brandon Vera, in the house here at the Rio Goku Koku Gikan, along with our many luminaries cage side. For the biggest show in history, it's one championship, a new era.
Look at the greatest flyweight world champion putting in work. Throws that kick, switches stances. It's so hard to get a read on DJ. Look at that. He throws the hook, attacks the legs, finishes the double leg. Look at that head position. That head driving into the body of Yu Wakamatsu. And then he started to suck the legs so he could keep the hips away from the cage so Yu wasn't able to get back up. DJ slowly starting to figure this out. He was able to get into side control, start looking for the submission, wasn't able to get it. But Yu Wakamatsu is doing a good job of stopping all of DJ's takedown advances. He's able to get back up to his feet and showcase good, so far, submission defense.
The Pancrase Flyweight Tournament champion, Wakamatsu, a 12-time world flyweight champion, Demetrius Johnson. And Johnson bounds out of his corner.
You can see a little bit of damage on the right eye of DJ. Those punches from Yu Wakamatsu are heavy.
Wakamatsu goes digging to the liver. Off that left hand, straight right down the center corridor. A beautiful counter from Wakamatsu. Sprawls out nicely, Wakamatsu. Jab kick from Wakamatsu, the heavy artillery. And DJ wants him down. DJ gets him down. Ties up those legs, presses him against the cage. On his back now.
Yuya got a little bit overexcited. He started to hunt. After he wobbled DJ a little bit, he went after him. And that was enabled DJ to duck under and secure that takedown. This is where DJ is very impressive. Watch him slowly make adjustments and work into side control.
And he goes, he passes from half guard to side control. Tries to pin the arm. And Wakamatsu back to his feet. Well done from Yuya again. Takes the back standing as DJ. Wakamatsu tries to turn back into him. What scramble, what a contact. Now DJ wants to try and choke it.
Good job by Yuya. He's able to create separation in the hands, turn his back to his body, but he can't stop. He has to continually defend because DJ is relentless.
Demetrius Johnson more moves than you hold here in the second round. Referee Olivia Coast right on top of the action. Wakamatsu could be in trouble.
He's got it looks like he's going for a choke. You can see he's got the side of the neck. It's like a no arm, arm triangle, but you can see that he's going for a rear naked choke, but good job by Yuya to scramble out of it. Now he's sitting in that. It's a bad spot. Look for the elbows. Watch the elbows on the ground and pound of DJ. He doesn't want to lose this position. He chooses actually to leave mount and go into side control. And I know what he's looking for. He's looking for a Kimura.
Fans.
Big hello to all of our viewers in the US watching on TNT. Hope you're enjoying all the action of one championship, all the action of Mighty Max, Demetrius Johnson.
She's framing off the face, just slides that elbow in. You can see he's trying to crucifix the arm. He's going to take that right arm of Yuya, put it between his legs so he can isolate, drop a little bit of ground and pound. Here comes the Kimura. He's looking for it. Good job by Yuya. It's nice and tight on the arms.
Johnson hunting for a finish as we approach the halfway mark of this contest. As Mitch said earlier, it's been a long, long time since Demetrius Johnson has been in a three-rounder. Now can he take that arm home? No, not yet. Here's some knees to the collarbone. Demetrius trying to choke it. Can he get it? Can he get it? It's the Nato lead! Hold on, wait a minute. Let me put some DJ in it.
Wow, he was able to get that choke from a nasty position. Didn't even have the full proper positioning. That's how tight the world champion squeeze is.
Demetrius Johnson, successful on his one championship debut, and he moves through to the semi-finals of the World Flyweight Grand Prix. That is why he's the greatest of all time. That's Mighty Mouse, Demetrius Johnson.
Look at this, has the guillotine. Yuya Wakamatsu did everything he could to try to avoid that, but look how tight that is. Look at the guillotine. You can see Yuya Wakamatsu tries to turn out of it. He tries to angle out, but look at that. Oh, that's a nasty position. That's how tight that is. Demetrius Mighty Mouse Johnson just moves forward in the one flyweight world grand prix.
Have a look at the squeeze from Mighty Mouse. Locks out moisture, seals in freshness. Good night, Irene.
Well, Yuya Wakamatsu did a really good job in the first half of that match. He was stopping a lot of takedowns, showcasing good striking. Very impressive performance from Yuya Wakamatsu. DJ's one of the very DJ could be the best flyweight in the world, and Yuya Wakamatsu was in there to the very end.
Let's go to Tom Lau, make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 40 seconds in the second round for your winner by way of guillotine choke, Demetrius Johnson!
Welcome to ONE Championship, Demetrius Johnson, the greatest of all time, takes the winner's medal and takes his place in the semi-finals of the World Flyweight Grand Prix. They've been staring each other down, and now the time for talk is over. Angela Lee, Zhong Jinan Lee, the atomweight world champion. Zhong Jinan, the strawweight world champion. Both come out slinging the hands. Zhong Jinan may have the edge in power in the hands. Angela will have the edge on the ground. Overhand there from Zhong Jinan, trying to back up Angela Lee. Goes to the body. Feel Zhong Jinan isn't quite settled here yet. Inside the opening 30 seconds, looks a little more jittery than Angela Lee.
Angela Lee's very composed. She's been there. She's been in these moments a long time, so she knows what to do, even at such a young age. The Lee clan has told me that Zhong Jinan gets disrupted when she gets hit. She starts to flurry. She starts to get wild when she gets touched up, and that's what Angela Lee's planning on doing. She wants to touch up the face of Zhong Jinan and get her to overcommit and then lead to the takedown. Right now, she's inside the clinch. Let's see what Zhong Jinan can do.
Angela Lee, atomweight world champion, 9-0, undefeated. Zhong Jinan goes to ground for the very first time. Top position for Angela Lee.
Very committed takedown by Angela Lee. Let's see what she can do now in side control.
And a pin that right arm of the champion and bangs away to the face between the eyes of Zhong Jinan.
This is a bad spot for Zhong Jinan. She's got to be composed. She's got to stay relaxed. She's got to try to work her way back into half guard, which she does. Now she's got to try to get an underhook on that side of where Angela Lee is. Angela Lee right now has an underhook on the right side of Zhong Jinan. So she has to try to get that underhook. She has to try to swim her right arm underneath the arm of Angela Lee and start to work her way up the cage. Angela Lee has tremendous top pressure.
Angela Lee right in front of her corner, her father and head coach Ken Lee, also her brother Christian Lee in the corner. You see them both there on the right of your screen. Her husband Bruno Pucci watching back in Hawaii on BR Live and TNT. Big hello to Bruno Pucci.
Breathe, Bruno.
On her back here, the champion, Zhong Jinan of China, who trains out of Bali MMA in Indonesia these days with Big Mike Clyde, Don Carlo Klaus and all the team there. One of their main sparring partners for this one was Tiffany Van Soest, who's also here in Tokyo.
Good job by Zhong Jinan to get her feet on the hips of Angela Lee and create a little bit of space. Angela Lee's jumping on the neck now. Possible front headlock. Let's see, Zhong Jinan's got to separate those hands. Works her way back up to the feet. In a bad spot for some knees. Angela Lee's looking for possibly a darce choke. She's got an opportunity here to slide her left arm onto her own bicep and clasp on a choke. I just choose to soften her up with the knees right now.
It's set for 5 rounds for the women's strawweight world title, but most pundits say it won't go that far. Gut munching knee there from Zhong Jinan, the champion, and she breaks away from the left hook.
Nice little confidence boost from Zhong Jinan to get back up to her feet. You can see the way she celebrated by clapping her hands. Now she's trying to shake out her hands.
I wonder if Jean's trying to play a counter game here with Angela. Wants Angela to strike first. Seems to be that way. Gets it with a nice left hand there to Zhong Jinan. Another left hand for the champion. And circles off counterclockwise. Drops the lead hand down to the bread basket. Now drifts off in the opposite direction. Angela ties her up again. Takes a knee to the upper left ribs.
Zhong Jinan's got to be careful in these clinch positions. She's allowing Angela to close too much distance. She has to circle around. She has to create movement. She has to create that chaos. Headlock takedown now. Zhong Jinan might be able to pop her head out. Good job. Get back into the separation.
Zhong Jinan threw a knee, broke off there. Let's see if she can hit the power salvos off her hands now. Zhong Jinan, the punching panda. Saw it come out on an absolute blaze when she entered one championship, tearing up Abriel Senio and then demolishing Tiffany Teo on her way to win that world title. Big right hand for the punching panda. Here she comes.
Nice right hands.
Angela Lee got her first real taste of Zhong Jinan's power in that right hand, bitch.
Yeah, Zhong Jinan answered those right hands with shots of her own.
Circling again. Counterclockwise is the champion. Good left hook, then rips down the liver, over and right into the numbers over.
Angela Lee's doing a good job, though, of cutting the angles of Zhong Jinan. You can see that pressure. She's trying to move in, get into that clinch, and work for that takedown. Zhong Jinan's trying to circle out, but Angela Lee's doing a good job of cutting her off. Looks like we might see a second round here in the show.
Angela did predict she would finish Zhong Jinan in the first. I don't think we're going to see that. Both women landing right hands. It was maybe Angela who drew the short straw. Thought about a front kick, did leave. And we go to the towels at the end of one. World champion Yosuke Tsuruta also in the house. He'll be on our next card. Main event in Manila, April 12 at the Mall of Asia Arena. Defending that belt against Joshua Pascio.
On the ground, this is where Angela is most dangerous. Look at her. She's got that front headlock position. She lands a nice knee to the left side of the face of Zhong Jingna. There's Zhong Jingna throwing that overhand right, catches the shoulder of Angela Lee. Angela Lee's doing a good job of defending. Zhong Jingna needs to mix things up a little bit. Constant movement, not allow Angela Lee to back her up into the cage. I like Angela Lee working into that clinch and dragging her down. She's got that nice little headlock takedown that she's using very effectively to put Zhong Jingna on her back and soften her up. Good round for Angela Lee.
Hey,
we are ready to rock and roll. Second round set for five for the world strawweight title. The atomweight world champion Angela Lee, the strawweight world champion Zhong Jinan, the sold-out Rio Goku Goku Geekan. Great choice for the first ever event of one championship in Japan. No greater building of martial arts history than here at the Rio Goku Goku Geekan. Hallowed hallways have been built by so many great martial arts champions over the years. Corking knee there from Zhong Jinan. Angela turns her around nicely, backs the champ against the cage.
She's very tight in that clinch position. She's got her hands locked. And she might try to step over inside, take her right leg across the body, and throw Zhong Jinan down again. She's got to try to swim in. She's got to create a little bit of space on that right side. She has to try to get her arm on underneath the arm of Angela Lee and break away.
Knee there from Zhong Jinan.
I see somebody turn the corner here. A little bit of redirection here.
Is Zhong Jinan playing the right game at the moment, Mitch?
Well, I don't know if it's the right game, but she's doing okay, and she's been able to get out of a few bad positions that Angela Lee's had her in. Now, Angela Lee is a black belt. She's submitted a lot of people, and Zhong Jinan's done a good job of keeping her composure and working her way back up to her feet. I'd like to see Zhong Jinan start throwing hands and then maybe some kicks, soften up the legs, throw those leg kicks to Angela Lee, and then circle out. She's allowing Angela Lee to back her up against the cage inside these clinch positions, but she's able to escape and create space. So that's going to build her confidence.
The space allows the strike, which is the power side of Zhong Jinan. Will she strike first? Does she want to play the counter game here with Angela Lee? Looking through her brow, threads the right hand. Lee, nicely done to cut off the movement of the champion. Looks for the right hand as Lee couldn't find it, resets herself. How do you see Lee carrying herself so far with this extra weight, Mitch, going up a weight division here to strawweight?
I think she looks great at strawweight. She was happy. She was composed all week, and she's going to be stronger. But you got to wonder, how did that back injury play into things? The back is involved in so many aspects of mixed martial arts, especially when you have a grappler. The strength of Angela Lee, how is that going to affect her game? And that could be part of the reason, I don't want to speculate, but part of the reason why Zhang Jinan's been able to escape a lot of these close encounters.
They were scheduled to compete against each other in November last year in Singapore. A bulging disc in the back of Angela Lee prevented that. And here we are in Tokyo tonight in the biggest card in history. One championship, a new era. Angela Lee backed against the cage, knees to the thigh there from Zhang Jinan. Lee turns her around.
Good job. That now she's working the underhook. See how she swam that arm in? Now she's got control. She likes her to jack that arm up. Otherwise, she might go for a ride here. Angela Lee's been able to drag her to the ground twice now. Good adjustment on the body position there from Zhang Jinan. Let's see if Angela Lee can get her down. Oh, a takedown attempt there from Zhang Jinan. She exits with a punch.
Zhang Jinan, an opportunity to work the hands. There's a nicely threaded overhand lead there. Circles off to her right, away from the power side of Angela.
Zhang Jinan looks a little bit stiffer than we've seen her in the past. You can see her shoulders are kind of shrugged up next to her ears. I don't know if that's a defensive tactic to far as rolling with the punches and, you know, using the shoulder to block it, but she looks a little bit stiffer than we've seen her in the past.
Mitch and Eve. Chance that part of the plan of Zhang Jinan may be to draw Angela into really deep water and test Angela at strawweight.
I mean, it makes sense. You know, it could be that Angela may start to fade in the later rounds. That's what they're hoping for. They're hoping to draw this out to see a third, fourth, and fifth round because they're hoping that Angela Lee, after her back injury, after her car accident, hasn't been able to put the time in on the mat. And that could be when Zhang Jinan chooses to step it up a level and really start pushing the pace, because she seems very composed and relaxed. She's not breathing heavy, neither of them are. And Angela Lee doesn't look to be fading at all.
Still great to see the hashtag One Championship trending tops in the USA right now on Twitter. Has been for the last hour and a half or so. Great to see. Big hello to all of our American viewers watching on TNT. Outside leg kick there from Angela. Roundhouse kick from Zhang Jinan. Under 30 seconds remain. Second round of five. Could it be the master plan of Zhang Jinan to draw Angela Lee to deep water? Test Lee's cardio. Test that extra weight. Step up side kick there. Zhang Jinan tries to back her off with the right hand. There's a left hook from the champion and an inside thigh kick. She talks to Angela. She pulls her forward. Angela's not going to be sucking into a brawl. She's too clever for that. They're going into another round.
Look at this, inside the clinch, Angela's doing good work. Look at that over-the-top elbow. Had the arm come down on Zhang Jinan. She was able to land a nice overhand elbow there. And then Zhang Jinan was finally able to have some success inside the clinch. Look at that beautiful little trip there from Zhang Jinan. She answers or exits with a punch. Good job from both these ladies in that round. We're starting to see them. You know, this is when that cardio is going to start to come into play. You know Zhang Jinan can go hard for five rounds. Angela Lee has gone hard five rounds in the past, but how is it right now?
If you want to win and all expenses paid, the VIP experience of One Championship, find out how now. Go to onefc.com/win. onefc.com/win and find out how you can win a very, very important person's experience.
Ready?
Third round of five for the strawweight world title. Angela Lee in the black, looking to become the first ever two-division women's champion at One Championship. Zhang Jinan looking to retain. A little more gusto behind both these martial arts champions here to start the third. Angela presses the champ against the cage.
Right now, Zhang Jinan's trying to get that underhook on that one side. You can see she's trying to go for a body lock. Angela's got her pressed up against the cage. She's got that driving that shoulder into the chin, into the chest there of Zhang Jinan. That's able to keep her pressed up against the cage like that. Zhang Jinan's now got the underhook. Might be able to circle out, and she does. usually goes for the body lock, changes levels. Let's see if she can get the takedown again. She's utilizing, she's changing up her game as far as the takedowns are concerned. Beautiful hip toss there. She grabbed the body lock. She was able to turn the corner and put Zhong Jin Na on her back. This is where Angela Lee is most dangerous.
Open guard here from Zhong Jin Na on her back. Let's see what Angela can do. So many submission variations that Angela is capable of. She can tie you up like a pretzel, like a ball of twine, and tap you out from anywhere. But what's Zhong Jin Nam been working on? She throws the legs up a little higher, Dragon.
She went for the rubber guard there. Let's see what she can do. She's trying to control the arms here of Angela Lee. She's got that guard nice and high, but he's trying to attack an arm. Nice in the face there of Angela Lee. Angela Lee takes that leg for a ride, puts her on her back.
Control for Angela Lee, cuts the hip in, does the atomweight champion of the world. North-south position now.
Looking for a Kimura, might possibly go for an armbar here.
Is Angela gonna take that arm home with her? Zhong Jin Na back to her feet and momentarily out of trouble. A back and forth contest, a seesawing battle for the strawweight crowd. Hear the pin drop silence in the Rio Goku Koku Giga, the most educated martial arts fans in the world here in Japan. I've been coming here for 18 years now, and they're always the same, Mitch. There are no smarter, no more appreciative fans in the martial arts world than the Japanese.
And there's a lot of technique for them to appreciate in this match here. Zhong Jin Na's got to keep that space. She has to keep that separation. Keep it in the middle of the cage. Allow her to do work with those hands. Angela Lee's controlling a lot of the exchanges inside the clinch.
Zhong Jin Na shakes out the hands. Resets as the champion. Fires out a front kick. Nicely placed to the midsection. Angela edging forward. Zhong Jin Na beats her with a punch. Two-punch combination. Overhand right from Zhong Jin Na. Past the halfway point of this entire match. Left hook, right hand, the old 3-2 there from Zhong Jin Na. Mitch, who would you have ahead at the moment?
Nice spinning back kick there from Zhong Jin Na. At this point, I would have to say Angela Lee's ahead just because she's controlling a lot of the exchanges on the ground and up against the clinch. But Zhong Jin Na is starting to turn it up right now. She's landed about 12 to 13 different shots here. Landed that spinning back kick.
Oh, left hook there from Zhong Jin Na. And Angela does a quick count of her teeth.
Angela's eating a few punches, but she's still remaining composed. Standing there in front. Not really shooting for takedowns either.
Loading up on these runs and left hooks in Zhong Jin Na. More hooks than a tackle box on the champion. And again, smack bang between the eyes. Overhand right from Zhong Jin Na. Goes for the headache maker. Looks for a side kick. Angela backed off again with the right hand from Zhong Jin Na. This is a great portion of the contest for the champion.
This has been the most successful portion of the time for Zhong Jin Na. Angela Lee was starting to get touched up there in that middle part of that round. You could see she was taking a lot of shots, but she's remaining composed and she's still pushing forward. Let's see Angela Lee change up the game here, start throwing leg kicks. Go for a takedown. She hasn't taken one shot yet. Her only takedown attempts have been in the clinch up against the cage.
Zhong Jin Na, chin tucked, looking through her brow. The champion's been on the money so far in the swing for the striking. Here she comes again. The chin rocks back on Angela Lee. There's an overhand right. There's a body shot. Lee's going to get off the cage here. And they clinch up. She locks down the arm to the champion. And here come the knees from Zhong Jin Na. What a round from the Chinese world champion, Zhong Jin Na. Angela threads a couple of knees to the right ribs. We do score on an overall contest, not round by round, but this has been a phenomenal round for Zhong Jin Na, a round in which the champion found her range. And look who we've got in the crowd tonight, Mitch.
Rafael Dos Anjos is here in Japan enjoying the Women's Strawweight World Championship. I know he's part of Evolve Mixed Martial Arts, and he's enjoying the work that Angela Lee has put in, at least in the first half of this contest. We have to wonder, is the second half of this contest gonna go the way of the Chinese Punching Panda? You can see her starting to overwhelm Angela Lee landing big shots, flurrying on her. Angela Lee's getting caught up in the commotion, the chaos created by the champ.
What I like there, we saw it on the replay, Mitch. Angela took two, I think it may have been three, solid right hands. She had the composure, though, to do a little pirouette, a little quarter turn, and then strike back with two punches of her own.
Yep. She's a high-level martial artist.
A lot of questions people had about what sort of punch Angela Lee could take from a heavier opponent from the punch It answered a lot of questions right there.
Well, we saw the punch coming from Mei Yamaguchi, the big right hand that dropped Angela Lee. Angela Lee was still able to come back. Ooh, she just caught a left hook there by Zhang Jinan.
Oh, the right hand from Angela tagged her on the chin. That was nicely done.
Like the change up here of game plan. Angela Lee going after the trip, getting Zhang Jinan to the ground.
You see the change of tact here from Angela Lee. They talked to her in the corner. They said, take it down. Let's not let her strike against you. Let's get it to ground. That's your territory. That's Leeville. That's Leeville.
Right as Zhang Jinan was starting to see a little bit of momentum, Angela Lee was able to put a stop to it and move on. Look, now she's inside. Now she's in half guard. Let's see what she can do here. Zhang Jinan's got to keep her nice and tight. She's got possibly the overhook on the opposite side. You can see that far arm was over the head of Angela Lee. She's got to try to get it under. I think now she's just trying to stall and wait possibly for a stand-up. Angela Lee's not going to allow the position to go inactive for very long. She's going to start doing work.
Angela Lee came in many people's eyes as the favorite for this one. Zhang Jinan, it looks like the game plan all along is to draw Angela into deep water. Close guard now from the strawweight champion, Zhang Jinan. Angela trying to posture up, trying to break it open, work some ground and pound back. Hammer fist strike there from the atomweight world champion.
Good job from Zhang Jinan to get back into guard. Feet on the hips.
Up kick there from Zhang Jinan. And another one. Angela, side control, nicely done. Let's see where she goes from here, Mitch.
You can see Zhang Jinan's trying to keep that head nice and close to her body to control the posture. She's trying to walk up the cage now. Create a scramble here. She's got to keep moving. She can't allow Angela Lee to start setting up these submissions.
Angela did not expect to be here. She thought she would have Zhang Jinan out in the first round. And here we are in the penultimate, the fourth of five. 3 minutes remaining. And now in what they do call the deep water. Side control still for Angela Lee. What are the options here for Lee? What can Zhang Jinan do, Mitch?
Right now she's got that head in control with her left arm. As she's going knee on belly, she might try to slide over into mount. Oh, Zhang Jinan gives up her back. Zhang Jinan might be able to escape out the back door, but she's got to be careful she doesn't give up her arm. Angela Lee's got a tight squeeze here. Might be an inverse triangle.
It looks like a demented game of Twister here between Zhang Jinan and Angela Lee. Angela always hunting for a way to finish when it's on the ground, when it's on the feet. And you know the punching panda wants to get back to striking range.
The way Angela Lee has that leg locked up. She's got that nice and tight. She's hunting after the arm right now. She does have the triangle possibly in. You can see how the triangle is locked up with her left leg underneath the knee of her right leg. And that's nice and tight. So she's gonna try to extend the arm here. She's gonna try to create a little bit of space and get.
Oh, is she gonna do it? Is she gonna tap out Zhang Jinan? Not yet. Referee Kim Chen right on top of it. Angela's going to try and soften up the champion a little more. Still 1 minute 35 remains in this fourth round. Angela wants the armbar. She wants to take the arm home. Could the title be slipping away from Zhang Jinan? Is Unstoppable going to make history? Is she? Can she?
It's not supposed to bend that.
Can she make history, Angela Lee? She's going for it.
Look how tight that is. Look how tight the triangle is. She can't go anywhere. Watch the thumb.
She's going for it. Will she become a two-division champion?
She's still got a minute to work here. Zhang Jinan's got to move. She's got to scramble.
Angela wants to take the arm home. Zhang Jinan surviving. But with what punishment? With what damage? Angela softens her up a little more. Can she sense a victory soon? Can she smell a sub coming?
This is a long time for Zhang Jinan to be trapped in this triangle. She's got to move. She can't go anywhere, though. She's just taking the beating.
Oh, here he goes again. That looks bad. That looks dangerous.
Dongjing Nan won't give up.
This is crazy. Dongjing Nan will not tap out. A belly down armbar from Angela Lee. And Dongjing Nan, look at her face. Look at her grimacing. But she gives a thumbs up to referee Kip Chang.
There's a bit of space there in the triangle. You can see she doesn't have quite have that choking because look at the legs.
Push
down near the calf, so she can't quite get that nice and tight. The armbar is there, though. Dongjing Nan, there's one quitter. She's okay.
Her face is turning purple. But the bell's almost here. A few more seconds. And the champion survived. The champion survived. We're going in to the fifth and final round.
That's hard. That's hard. Hard. Her family keeps her in the match. She won't quit. There's no quit. Fifth round. At this point, that's a near finish. Look at this. Parries the hand down. Gets the hands deflected away and comes right through the middle with a face rattling right hand. Beautiful. Then she slips underneath. The counter shot gets into the clinch, and that led to the triangle we just saw. That was a long time to be trapped inside that reverse triangle.
Folks, come and join us. Come and see a ONE Championship event live. All expenses paid. It's on us. To find out how, go to onefc.com/win. onefc.com/win. We'll bring you to ONE Championship. All expenses paid. We are seeing a gripping match for the strawweight world title. The survival of Dongjing Nan, the champion, in front of a sellout crowd inside the Ryogokugokugikan in Tokyo, Japan. The ONE Championship, a new era. 5 minutes remains for either Dongjing Nan to retain or for Angela Lee to become an historic two-division world champion. Early trade of leather here. Dongjing Nan showing damage around the right eye.
Angela Lee took two shots, shook her head, said, you got nothing on me. Dongjing Nan's gonna need a big round if she's gonna wanna take this. Well, she has to go for the finish. Nice body kick. Angela Lee scrimmaged just a bit on it.
Side kick there from Dongjing Nan. Knees almost went. There was the power of the champion. She goes to the body.
Looks exhausted at this point. There's not a lot coming back from the atomweight champ.
And this is what Dongjing Nan wanted. This was the game plan all along. Draw her into deep water and punish her in the fifth round. Let's see what Dongjing Nan to do now.
I think Angela Lee might have blew her gas tank out when she went for that triangle armbar finish. She is, her mouth is wide open. She's taking big shots.
This is Dongjing Nan's time. This is when she's going to go. She's going to pull out all the stuff. Throw caution to the wind. Angela Lee is blowing heavy. We've never seen Angela like this before. And here comes Dongjing Nan with the overhand right. Another side kick. Straight into the guts of the atomweight champion. And a high hand. Angela's hurt. The body shot hurt her. The punching panda. Angela's in trouble. Angela's in trouble. It's over. It's over. It's good night, Irene. That was the play. Dongjing Nan, the unstoppable has been stopped.
The body shots did it. She started kicking the body. You can see Angela Lee didn't have anything left in the fifth and final round. She put it all in to that triangle armbar finish. And when Dongjing Nan was able to survive the fourth round, she came back. The flurry and still ONE strawweight world champion Dongjing Nan.
No, Mitch, she did not tell us the game plan yesterday when we begged her to tell us, but it was evident by the time the third round rolled. She wanted to draw her into the fourth and fifth. She knew that Angela would gas out, and she punished her, and she retains the crown. What a performance from Dongjing Nan.
The body shots, you can see right there. Angela Lee winces, and Dongjing Nan jumps all over here, landing big shots. The kicks to the body were the ones that did it. Look at this, super slow-mo, straight right hand to the solar plexus, crumbles the atomweight champion, and then Dongjing Nan kept going after it. What a performance to stop Unstoppable and retain her belt.
Let's go to Tom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, presenting the belt for this match, please welcome Mr. Chatri Sityotong, founder, chairman, and CEO of ONE Championship. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kent Chang, has called a stop to this contest after 1 minute and 37 seconds in the fifth and final round for your winner by way of technical knockout, and still ONE Women's Strawweight World Champion, Xiong Jing Nan!
Xiong Jing Nan retains the gold, presented there by the CEO and founder of ONE Championship, Chatri Sityotong. China's greatest mixed martial artist right there. Xiong Jing Nan does what many thought was unthinkable. She stopped the unstoppable Angela Lee.